Today I greet my viewers with another liberal message from such progressive politologist like Madman. As a human rights advocate and actually immigrant from Russia, I actually want to give a few comments on what was the elections, Russian presidential elections, which is supposed to take place on March 4th this year. Actually, the point is that with the notorious Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, who has been former president, used to be a president, conservative Russian president, for two terms, for two full terms, and about a couple times more, two more terms of being Russian Prime Minister with corrupt Russian President Boris Yeltsin. He actually now violates constitution, Russian Constitution, and illegally, you know, trying to impose his totalitarian and corrupt rule on Russian public, you know, and actually, and I believe that, you know, a large number of Russian progressive public, progressive intelligentsia, intellectuals, will actually protest at this illegal attempt to violate Russian constitution and trying to you know, to ram with corrupt monster Vladimir Putin, former Russian ex-president, a social conservative, into politics, you know. And I believe that now the Russian president, Mr. Medvedev, he used to be quite liberal about raising social liberal, about raising wages of both military personnel and police officers. He actually, unfortunately, himself endorsed with Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin to become a third-term president, ignored the Russian constitution and violated it in a very severe manner, you know, which actually would probably call for judicial retribution against Dmitry Medvedev and with corrupt Russian president and former director, of, you know, chairman of Russian Gazprom, so-called gas monopoly. And I believe that most Russian public, mostly Russian, all Russian, majority of Russian intellectuals will actually oppose any attempt to violate Russian constitution and bring that corrupt and totalitarian monster called Vladimir Putin, you know, to power. And actually, as being born and raised in Moscow, Russia, you know, being an immigrant, I actually very much resent that nationalist monster, Vladimir Putin, who thinks he can do anything he wants in his country, taking bribes and actually persecuting journalists and assassinating journalists, like he assassinated Anna Politkovskaya. As he admitted, Vladimir Putin, Russian Prime Minister, admitted that Anna Politkovskaya's statements were actually had caused damage to Russian prestige. As public admitted, YouTube.com, where I watched his speech, you know. But all Anna Politkovskaya wrote was Russian, Putin's Russia. And when she claimed that Russian, ex-Russian President Vladimir Putin had used to be on the payroll of a famous Russian mobster, his name was Fizulov or something, from Uralmash, a Russian mobster who took over Uralmash, Russian kind of heavy machinery plant at the Urals area. And actually, late Russian journalist Anna Politkovskaya had been assassinated by hired Putin death squad goons, you know, mentioned that she didn't like Vladimir Putin a number of times. So I believe that maybe when Vladimir Putin had personally tried to hit on Anna Politkovskaya, but while she received received a personal rejections, he decided to assassinate her and ordered his Russian Ministry of Domestic Affairs General, Major General Pavlichenko, to assassinate Anna Politkovskaya personally, and lately a statement of a member of Russian investigatory commission, Markov, Russian investigatory committee, you know, so-called Следственный комитет, Markov stated that Russian Ministry of Domestic Affairs, Major General Pavlyuchenko, had a death squad, had hired a few Chechens to murder innocent people in Russia to provoke war between Russia and Chechnya. And those Chechens had been actually an employee of the Russian Major General Pavlyuchenko as death squad. Were actually indicated and caught, you know, caught red-handed with the murder of Anna Politkovskaya. But unfortunately, we organized a mastermind behind this assassination. Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, you know, got away with assassination, you know. And unfortunately, he trying to run his nationalist campaign again. And I believe that Vladimir Putin also was indicated in the murder of Alexander Litvinenko, you know, who had blamed ex-Russian President Vladimir Putin in killing Anna Politkovskaya. He had sent two Kremlin goons, former member of KGB, FSB, Federal Security Service, successor of KGB, terrible, you know, kind of secret police of totalitarian communist regime. Yuri Lugovoy and Alex, and Kovtun, as well Dmitry Kovtun, you know, to assassinate, poison Russian defector, ex KGB lieutenant Alexander Litvinenko with polonium 210. As they poisoned, I believe that Yuri Lugovoy, former KGB FSB officer, led by Russian Prime Minister Igor Gaidar, had poured, you know, radioactive isotopes of polonium-210 into a tea, which was offered by Dmitry Kovtun, and now a member of Kremlin death squad. And actually, nowadays, Russian President Dmitry Medvedev claims that Russia won't extradite Yuri Lugovoy, as he's a member of Russian Duma, Russian Parliament. And I believe that it's, in case, such case, we don't know where it's addition, but we always, at least investigation. We should invite Scotland Yard investigators to Russia, to Moscow, and bring all those copies of their documents to Russian Minister of Domestic Affairs, and start investigation about, open investigation about the murder of assassination of Alexander Litvinenko, a late Russian KGB defector, who's been poisoned to death by a radioactive isotope of polonium-210 in London. And because they claimed he sold out to the British intelligence service MI6. And I believe that this was a terrorist act. And even while I was actually myself, unfortunately, was persecuted by Russian spies in Hollywood, in California, in Southern California. And one of the female Russian spies who was actually taking a swim in a swimming pool in the Hollywood Bailey, told me that for the things I was writing about Russia, she would have me shot to death. But I told her that she should herself been shot to death in such a case, you know. Just trying to get back to the offenders. But we actually, yeah, Russian spies were looking for a chance, of course, to commit assassination. They were all were critics, including me, myself, you know, your humble servant of the public, you know, and American public. And I believe that there would be more demonstrations, there would be more protests against the corrupt rule of Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin and his corrupt boss Dmitry Medvedev, with liberal, so-called liberal demagogue, who actually does nothing to raise the minimum wage of Russian workers. Instead, he keeps Russian doctors and nurses and teachers in extreme poverty, and the reason raising their in the teachers' wages, about 30%, or maybe $30 US dollars. It's minimal. It's pretty good. I don't say that it's bad, but it's actually too small. You know, $30 that mean very little. Increase in the welfare of those teachers, Russian teachers, which actually, and when it comes down to finances, corrupt social conservative Russian member of Russian parliament, Gosduma, Mitrofanov stated that at a TV show, Svoboda and Spravedlivost, so justice and freedom, you know, and that Russian parliament didn't have any money, you know, to improve the plight of those state workers. And it comes to social justice, such corrupt fetzo, with Mitrofanov, member of Russian, conservative member of Russian Duma, from a United Russia or whatever, considered that they didn't have any money for workers, for state workers, didn't have any money to keep people above the poverty line. And what was the problem of Russia? Well, actually, if a Russian social conservative such as Vladimir Putin comes to power again illegally by violating Russian constitution and ramming himself the third time to a public who's fed up with violating Russian constitution two-term limit on presidency, well, actually, it will happen, turn to his corrupt rule will end up in revolution and nothing else. And revolution will overthrow corrupt Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin and his insane rule of nationalism and corruption, you know, and persecution of journalists. Well, remember that mud in the snow kind of attack against Gusinski and TV when he, actually the station was criticized. Ex-President Vladimir Putin was shut down illegally by authorities according to the information law that has been issued in 1993. In which any edition that criticized the Russian government was subject to closure by the government in Ministry of Information, you know. As I read it in the newspapers, in 1993, while selling, retail stuff to customers in a small retail kiosk in Russia, back in Russia. And I believe that Russian President Vladimir Putin is capable of excesses, or capable of sending his spies terrorizing immigrants abroad, his critics abroad, such as once he proved by sending a spy to break down my vehicle and spying on me in Hollywood, California, and where I had a temporary protection status from Federal Protective Service and from Department of State, where actually they didn't protect me, and Russian spy, Armenian, former KGB officer, Armenian guy, Armenian male in his 15, you know, ordered a mechanic in our KGB spy, former Russian spy, to actually to destroy my vehicle, you know, and they broke down my vehicle's computer box, smashing it against the floor of the Hollywood auto shop. Actually, my vehicle ended up spinning around on the freeway, you know, and I survived by miracle, simply. You know, so that assassination attempt on part of Russian spies, former KGB officer, decided to show me how to criticize the president is another example that Russian, corrupt Russian nationalist prime minister Vladimir Putin and his corrupt boss Dmitry Medvedev are engaged in politics of espionage called war against the critic against the West. And I believe U.S. government should take serious measures in order to curb attempts of terrorism, espionage on part of corrupt nationalist regime of Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin and his corrupt nationalist boss from United Russia, Dmitry Medvedev. I remember that Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin had declared Russian people to be cheap ones and tried to lure Western investment by telling the Western investors directly that Russian workers were cheap, in his own words, and were cheaper than American workers. And but I believe that those Russian workers are simply scabs, because they want only, if they want to work for less than $500 a month, they actually make them living below poverty line. And I believe that If anybody would buy such a poverty downward driven race of a button, is actually neo-fascist only. And might attract, you know, neo-fascist France and West, but not always. And then Vladimir Putin, actually, there is a good analysis of Vladimir Putin's recent motions, pre-election motions at the Moscow Times. We can watch modern edition of Moscow Times at moscowtimes.com/news. In this article said Putin bristles at West in foreign policy text. Unfortunately, there was no original Vladimir Putin, Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin speech in the Moscow Times. Now, whatever, well, I searched actually all those anchor text, all those editions, and even his Russian version, 6,000 words article, it's also unavailable for Moskovsky Novosti edition, you know, even its original Russian language edition, it's totally unavailable. So there is even was a reaction, social concern. They hide that Vladimir Putin article from people, and himself, Russian conservative Vladimir, Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, was actually seeking corrupt influence at the Russian Association of Industrialists, where he was demagoguing and lying to public what he would about the taxation of the wealthy, which he's not going to raise any taxes against the wealthy. We're not going to find money for working class people. He wasn't going to find more money for teachers and police officers and other state workers and doctors, you know, and medics, because he's a neo-fascist. And I believe that if a majority of Russian people vote for such a neo-fascist like Vladimir Putin, insane nationalists who actually promote Cold War against his critics, such as me, myself, your humble servant, and we actually, I believe that at least the Russian public will actually, most progressive one will try to stop Vladimir Putin by becoming a president for the first time. It's illegal and likely to violate Russian constitution, you know. Article about constitution term limit of 2 terms. And this is outrageous. I mean, in the insanity of the situation, that Vladimir Putin lost his mind when he violated the constitutional limit of 2-term presidency. Also, in the article, Putin bristled at West in foreign policy text. He criticized West people, West for actually explicitly for supporting human rights, which he found that he was a Cold Warrior, you know, beset by his urges to defeat human rights activists. And he also promised that his country would detach itself from the outside world. Nevertheless, he lashed out, Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin lashed out in the United States, accused of meddling in Russian internal affairs by supporting some protest leaders. But actually, he cannot actually prevent Russian people, you know, to protest against him as a nationalist leader. And I believe Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin himself is a German spy. He sold out to German imperialists and sold out Russian workers as cheap shots to the West, you know, as he a corrupt scoundrel who used to take extort money from, you know, defected Russian tycoon Vladimir Berezovsky, so-called Bob, member of a Russian corrupt Russian clique of Russian president, late Russian president Boris Yeltsin, who was forgiven by now corrupt his own former director of secret police FSB, Vladimir Putin, and actually this is outrageous. So far, with trying to say that save off the Lybian version of the Russian problem, but Vladimir Putin is actually represents the same problem that late dictator Muammar Gaddafi, Libyan dictator, represented himself. That's a problem of corruption growing statewide, growing through the head of a state. In my article, he didn't mention the reset with the United States, saying merely that while much has been done to develop ties in recent years, attempts to fundamentally change them have failed, partly because of persistent stereotypes and phobias, quote-unquote. In this article, multiple times, when Putin bristles at West in foreign policy texts, which I was quoting to you, from the moscowtimes.com/news/article, Vladimir Putin actually, especially he was resented the influence of the United States, and once he actually called the United States hooligans, he called such a hooligan with been occurring in the United States, won't happen in Russia. So he actually opposes freedom and human rights, which happened in the United States, which become a cornerstone of American policy. He opposes it, and he will never allow that Russians who live at poverty line at making about 10,000 rubles or $300, $330, $333 a month, you know, from ever reaching, you know, decent living, you know, if we vote for that Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin. So that his election actually is a cornerstone that Russian press is trying to push him, corrupt Russian press trying to push Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin into presidential seat illegally and mostly being bribed and suborned, like by the Russian Prime Minister himself and his corrupt money launderer, inner circle of friends like Boris Berezovsky, who is the personal money launderer of Vladimir Putin's. Actually, as he paid hush money, extortion and racketeering money to Vladimir Putin, while Vladimir Putin was actually his friend and actually former director of the Russian Secret Service, FSB. And I believe that Boris Berezovsky was telling the truth when he confessed that ex-Russian President Vladimir Putin had and ex-Russian head of political police, former KGB political police, Federal Security Service, FSB, had extorted money from Boris Berezovsky, extorted stock of NTV, and received stock of NTV, and a large amount of stock of NTV, independent TV station, from that Russian tycoon from illegal privatization, Boris Berezovsky, who fled to London. And by the end, there is an outstanding warrant against Boris Berezovsky, should be delivered in London. And Russian authorities refused to deliver that outstanding arrest warrant to Interpol. It should have been arrested him anywhere Boris Berezovsky shows up abroad. And that way we'll be able to catch him, you know. Or should have sued him in British court, bringing copies of the prosecution case to Scotland Yard. And conferring and integrating and cooperating with British judicial authorities in order to indict and prosecute Boris Berezovsky in London for embezzling and grand theft of Russian state property. As we claim that Russian tycoon Boris Berezovsky has stolen a good deal, a good part of Russian state airplane, commercial airplane company called Aeroflot. Well, actually, according to press remarks, and actually, also, unfortunately, he, in that article, Putin Bristol at West, in the foreign policy article text, he, Vladimir Putin explained that increased trade and investment between both countries is obviously to improve political ties. But complained that regular U.S. attempt political engineering, including election campaigns, counter such policies. So that Vladimir Putin looking for, like an experienced racketeer, looking for a chance to stymie any trade, any attempts of trade in the United States, as the United States mostly opposed his corrupt policies, practice of extortion and racketeering. And I remember myself was living in Russia while that Kudrin, which I recognized later on in that in the TV footage of his cabinet, had managed to prevent me, you know, personally, you know, from obtaining foreign passport, you know, to travel abroad. Foreign passport in my own name, and actually I was unfairly denied a foreign passport to travel abroad. And when I received the appointment for more liberal. Director of Russian Ovir, Moscow Ovir, I don't remember the guy's name, but he actually was so kind as to granted me a pass, foreign passport. After he asked me one quiz question, who was actually the main star in a motion picture, in Russian motion picture, Adventures of Italians in Russia. I asked correctly that quiz. I just told him Andrei Mironov. And he instantly granted me foreign passport. So I won the quiz and was a winner, actually. Really, of this audience with that top Russian, one of the top Russian officials of Russian President Boris Yeltsin, for which I voted for, of course, while being a Russian citizen. And now I'm American citizen, I'm a patriot, and actually I denounce Russian citizenship, and I have only one singular American citizenship. And, you know, and I want to mention that Kudrin, you know, the guy who had been ousted by Russian president from United Russia, Dmitry Medvedev, former leader of Gazprom, gas selling Russian state monopoly. And actually, that very Kudrin guy was called by Vladimir Putin, Russian prime minister, his valuable friend. He is not available because he actually organized persecution, racketeering attempts against immigrants when he trying to extort money from them, knowing that they received payments, received some money for their sold apartments in, where they used to live, you know. And this is the kind of Russian political executive Vladimir Putin is. He's a racketeer extortionist, he's a nationalist who was behind that nationalist group that terrorized potential immigrants in high schools. Like me, your humble servant can actually testify that Vladimir Putin was one of the leaders of a nationalist movement in Russia, where he trained and coached Russian nationalists to become extortionists and racketeers, and taught them attacks against potential immigrants. Like I was attacked and by extortionist racketeers in my high school, middle school, with older guys, nationalists, who actually assaulted me and extorted money from me, and I had to pay them some extortion fees, like maybe a few rubles, you know, in change for me, in change, in small change, and yeah, and I recall that too. And I believe that, unfortunately, it will be a tragedy for Russian public if corrupt Russian Prime Minister, social conservative Vladimir Putin, gets elected the third time, because it ended up in a revolution, a very bloody revolution, and that failed effort to kill Putin revealed is just the top of the iceberg. Discontent of the Russian public will grow, and I believe most Russian journalists will join me in condemning the corrupt rule of Russian ex-Russian President Vladimir Putin, who actually terrorized journalists, who actually threw them out of a country, who actually planted bombs at their apartments, and who killed, ordered his death squads of Russian MVD Major General Pavlyuchenko, killed journalists such as Anna Politkovskaya, in the porches of their own homes. Yeah, and I believe that Russian Prime Minister should step down, should resign, and he shouldn't run for any third term president, because that will be disaster, big time. And yesterday I even watched his, United Russia's meeting to get Vladimir Putin elected on C-SPAN, when we bought time for C-SPAN, and actually shown that Vladimir Putin, how he actually, what kind of totalitarianist and nationalist he is. It's the only thing he could show for himself, and he doesn't stand for any progress. He's a very reactionary Russian Prime Minister, and he stands only to be an imperialist, a Russian imperialist, who only wants to corrupt the racketeering rule, and probably imagines he is actually some kind of monarch or royalty that can actually do whatever he wants in Russia. But which is wrong. And he will just, Russian revolution will prove him the contrary. Unfortunately, as the most of the times that come claims that the article Putin bristles at West in foreign policy text, recent anti-American calls by Putin commentator on state television have heightened fears that Vladimir won't survive the leadership change in the Kremlin, quote-unquote, from article Putin bristles at West in foreign policy text. We can watch this article at moscowtimes.com on the internet. Actually, yeah, which just confirms the same very fears that I have that ex-president Vladimir Putin will resort to his policy of persecuting journalists, was criticizing the government, and extorting money from immigrants, like he does through corrupt customs officials, used to do, and extorting a large amount of money from people who are trying to travel abroad. And while prohibiting them to travel abroad, if they have taken a loan, using their own homes as collateral. So with Vladimir Putin will conduct anti-immigrant human rights violating politics and should be removed from power by any means necessary for it. And the sooner Russian judicial power removes Vladimir Putin from presidential race, the better off Russian public will be. One of the fellows of the World Security Institute based in Washington, Nikolai Dubin, even said that anti-Western reflex was important for election campaigning with Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, nationalist and social conservative. Also, Vladimir Putin, as the Russian Prime Minister, opposes anti-missile shield in Eastern Europe, as he actually sold out to Iranian interests, and he had only interest of selling nuclear power equipment to Iran, and actually will just weigh down only Israeli bombardments of Iranian nuclear facilities as soon as Israeli intelligence receiving reports of that Iranian produced bomb-grade uranium. Immediately, we will follow a bombardment raid against Iranian facilities. We will destroy them efficiently, including the bunker buster bombs, which Israeli military will use definitely. So that it's inevitable this kind of retribution on part of Israel, preventive strike against Iran, whose elected official President Ahmadinejad has threatened to destroy the state of Israel. So it means called war against the state of Israel, which actually will be retributed by Israeli air raids of Israeli air jets against Iranian nuclear facilities. Well, I think that there is some legal justice in the world. Social justice and legal justice don't always prevail, but sometimes it takes a revolution for social and legal justice to prevail, I believe, in most cases. And sometimes it's not. Sometimes just evolution and development as, will help. It depends. In the countries and societies where democracy has a firm rule, actually, rule of law is actually guaranteed as a judicial and legal process. And actually, the rule of law probably will prevail. And international law allows eye for an eye politics of retributed or preventive attacks against governments of most countries which get ready to commit genocidal politics of killing innocent people. For instance, Vladimir Ahmadinejad looking for a chance to wipe out, obliterate the state of Israel by nuclear bombardments. So that Israel, people of Israel have a right to fight for their own survival and will wipe out the nuclear facilities of President Mohammed Ahmadinejad off the earth. So that if I think that we get too deep, you know, to get them, there are bunker buster bombs to get underground, deeply hidden nuclear facilities as well. And I believe a Cold War with Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin leads against the West, against the United States, he will be defeated. He will be the loser of that Cold War. and the United States will be winners of the Cold War and will defeat the corrupt rule and will have Vladimir Putin quit the government post and resigning with disgrace, like he deserves.